Hey, thanks. I'm just hoping it will not jump around like it was jumping around before. Because it was jumping around, I think because of this landing legs are unstable. So what I'm doing now is I just removed the landing legs. Maybe this will bring some stability, but I'm not sure how good is it resting on the docking ports right now. I guess we'll see. So let's open the panels. Let's also move all the fuel downstairs. So keep our center of mass nice and low. I think it will help. Let's see. So electric charge is increasing, which is good. I'm happy with this move. Now I want to connect everything from the central point over here, but I don't know if it's possible at all. I might make a central point over here and connect everything from here. Let's try that. Yeah, let's try that. Let's move to this one over here. Turn on the light because it's important. The milestone. We have started constructing the first outpost on Duna. Yep, we did. This is radiator. So from here I will make a connection to both here and here, and we'll see how it will improve or decrease the stability. Alright. CVA. Let's save too. What we have here. This connector. So we're gonna put it over here, I guess. Like this. And from here, there should be a connector on this baby. Nucleus says, nice base. Hi Nucleus, welcome to the stream. Thank you. Oh, there's a connector over here. Let's move it. This. So we will move it over here. I also noticed that when I was drilling over here, the base would rotate. So it was rotating. And because of that, all kinds of screwery was going on. So let's hope there will be no screwery this time. Because that would be unfortunate. So let's put a connector. I'm guessing over here? No, it's too far. Well. Can I put it here? I guess I can. Oh wow. Alright. Right on the engine. Stay the connector. Put it in a slot. Like this. Now. What we can do, K Can we grab another connector from the same location? I don't think so. No, it doesn't work this way. So from one location I can only grab one connector. And then I connect here, for example. And here I will not connect because this one is just storage, so we don't need it. Alright. Let's go back inside. Oh god damn it. Yep. Alright. So this should work. Let's save. And let's try. Alright. We're nice and docked. Let's start the drilling. Okay, drilling is being done. The electric charge has been reduced little by little. Which is not the end of the world. It's only one charge per second. Which gives me around what? 20 minutes. Which is not ideal. I need more power. How does this work? Sun exposure 72. Yeah, those are fine. Let me see how this works. Will it reduce sun exposure? It should reduce sun exposure because you can see it's in the shadow. There is no sun that's reaching this panel. So it shouldn't work. But it works. Okay. Anyway, let's retract this. These work, right? Yeah, those work. No problem here. Okay, I guess that's the best we can do right now. Until the second lander lands. This is what we're dealing with. So let's recharge. Refuel everything. Let's see if it works. So far so good. Let's see what happens when we exit the time acceleration. Alright, I think it worked. Okay, I'm not against that. Now let's see how the fuel creation will work. Start ISRU LFOX. Okay, I'm getting some fuel. Beautiful. Getting some fuel. Little by little. It takes a lot of charge. Electric charge is just plummeting right now. So we really need those cell fuels. Fuel cells, obviously. Which I think we have on the second lander. The second cargo. Yeah. We only made a little bit of fuel this time. But I guess now it will reduce the efficiency of the fuel making while keeping the... It's not actually keeping the harvesting. So it doesn't harvest, but it's making fuel. Okay, so let's accelerate. Uh-oh, there was a movement, right? When I started acceleration, there was movement. No, it didn't move. Do you swear? Swear to me. Okay, let's save here, actually. Before we do that, let's warp. Think this happened. So we now converted all our ore into the fuel and it only took us one day. So every day I will make 400 units of fuel plus oxidizer, and it will take us around a week to refuel right now using this configuration. Which is not ideal, but we'll take it. Alright, let's start harvesting again. I swear it moved right now. Oh, okay. Is that okay? Nothing destroyed? Alright, nothing destroyed. We recharge everything. Refuel the lander. Beautifully done. Full of ore. Stop surface harvesting. Stop ISRD. Maybe we could also create monopropellant, so let's make that. It's night time right now, so it's difficult to make power. Once we landed the second delivery, we will have nighttime power production because we have nuclear reactors there. Which is nice. Let's see. Let's see what we can do. Let's wait till morning. Make monopropellant. Ready. Okay. So there we go. There we go. Undocked. Now what we have to do is we have to detach our connector from here. Put it back. Now we detach our connector over here, the socket. Let's put it in the inventory. There you go. Let's go inside. Oh, what the hell is it? Ah, it was here. I saw it. I saw the board. Yep. I saw it right there. Oh, come on. There. God damn it. I missed it again. There. There you go. Alright. So, right now, we could possibly leave everything as is and go to orbit and deliver the second payload. Alright. Let's open the legs. It up. Beautiful. Connection is ready. Let's see, where is our stations? There is a space station refinery. There's nothing here. Should be a probe, maybe. Maybe a relay probe. What is it here? No. Maybe it is a probe. No. So what is it? It's not a station. Okay, let's see what they have. Oh, they think it's a rover. Okay, if you say so. So let's set a target. We are here right now. This thing is in a low orbit. It will pass over here and over here. Right now there is no point in going to space. Let's wait a little bit. And when we go to space, we point ourselves into 90 degrees over here on a navigator, and that should take us to the rovers. It's not really rovers, it's a transporter, but that's okay, I don't mind. No, we don't need a translation for this. We will work on the full capacity. So we turn off the translation, and what we want is to prepare the orbital mechanics. And over here we actually don't have any SAS. No, there should be. Yeah, there we have SAS. That's fine. So we're gonna use SAS to bring us to orbit. Let's see which we are controlling right now. It should be a lander. That's a battery. That's a adapter. That's battery again. Huh. What is this? No, that's not it. Is this it? Yeah, I think so. Remote guidance unit, there you are. Let's dock it right now. See, this is a ship, he thinks. Actually, it's a lander. Duna 3. Lander. Okay. Accept. So this lander doesn't have any space for gerbils, and we don't need gerbils right now. But that means we always have to maintain the connection. So we're gonna wait until the connectors come on this side of the planet, and then we launch. So F5 and wait. So we're gonna make orbit at around, how high is the gravity of, how high is the atmosphere of Duna? Somebody knows? Somebody knows in the chat? No? I think Duna is about, I don't know, 40, something like that. Maybe a 40. That's what I think. So yeah, we have plenty of fuel. So let's start moving. Ready to roll.